Manasi madam, just one thing. Who is one more in this? I mean,
Yeah.
with the name Manu, I'm not
Oh,
aware, so I'm just
yes.
asking.
Okay. Manu is, you can see two girls there, young ones. They are our Conception Limited's young staff, and there's Manu is Manasi. Manasi, say hi. She's Manu.
Hi.
So we call her Manu because she's also Manasi. And Jayashree.
Hello, ma'am.
Okay.
Manu is also Rupari student.
Okay.
She has done
Oh.
MSc Oceanography from Rupari. Okay.
Okay.
And
Okay.
ma'am, even I am master's from Rupari College.
She is also
Yeah,
PhD.
I think I have seen Chetali
Yes,
sometime. I
ma'am.
don't know
Yes,
when,
ma'am. Because
but
I was there for my
yes.
graduation as well as post graduation there.
Yeah, so this is a familiar face for me.
Yes,
And
ma'am. Jayashree is
yes.
chemical engineer. Say hi,
Oh,
Jayashree.
okay.
Hi, ma'am.
Okay,
Yeah,
so
hi.
let's start with the interview. Abir, hello. So this is our young
Hello, ma'am.
scientist Abir from sixth standard, from grade
Oh.
six. And Abir, there are two judges here. One is Chetali Miss. She's from Sophia, sorry, Sathe College. And Patki Madam, Dr. Mugdha Patki, she is from Ruparel College. So they are going to talk with you. So I'm sure you will enjoy this presentation. Are you ready with your presentation, Abir?
Yes.
So, ma'am, shall we start?
Yes.
Abir, you can start.
My name is Abir Ramya Mandlik. I'm from grade 6 Sishuman School. We all use measurements in our daily life at least three times in a day. And we find measurements even where we don't expect them, like in cooking. In cooking, we use measurements like tablespoons or teaspoons and those kind of stuff, and cups. We also use measurement in like the amount of spices to put, or standardized measures like grams or milliliters. We also use measurement in time, like digital watches and analog clocks. When we go to buy any grocery item, the grocer charges us accordingly to the weight of the thing that you're buying. So measurement is there too. We also estimate the amount of toothpaste that we put on a brush, which is like about the size of a pea, or 3 milligram, 3 grams. A doctor checks our parameters like our weight and our height to determine the amount of medicine we should be taking. And also the tailor determines the size of the shirt, like small, medium, large, XL, double XL, triple XL. This is the tape measure that our tailor uses to measure our waist length and height. And also in currency, like in currency we use like different rupees, like 1 rupee or 2 rupees, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, and 20 rupees. And we also use notes, like 10 rupee note, 20 rupee note, 50 rupee note, 100 rupee note, 200 rupee note, 500 rupee note, and 2000 rupee note. Also in sports, like in sports, you need to determine, like in football, you need to determine the amount of force you need to use to kick the ball, and also the distance the ball needs to travel. Thank you.
Thank you, Abir. Nice. You have told us very nicely about the measurements. So many measurements you have told. Abir, can I ask you one question?
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
You have shown initially the cup for measuring, then those spoons, and you have shown even that measuring tape, what Taylor uses. Have you used any time any one of these measuring instruments to measure anything?
Yes, I have used the cups sometimes to bake with my mother. I've never used a tape, but my grandmother uses it to measure the amount of cloth she needs.
Okay. You have used those cups, right?
Yes.
You said while helping your mother. What did you measure with the cup?
The amount of flour you need, or the amount of oil you need in the cake, or the amount of sugar, the amount of salt, all those kind of measurements.
Okay. So, suppose when you put it in some cup, I am having, say, this cup. It is not your kind of cup, but this is a cup. And if I am going to put flour in this, okay? And if I have a heap of that flour like this, is it correct?
It's not correct, because there will be more than the actual amount that should be there.
Okay. And what about oil or water? Should it be exactly up to this rim?
Yeah.
Or is it it should be exactly up to the rim.
But even if you pour more water, it'll just spill down. So no harm done.
Yeah. Harm will be there, because you are wasting that oil or water. Yeah. Anyway.
But nothing will go inside the thing that you're making.
Correct. Yeah. Your cake won't spoil.
Yeah.
Because the measurement is different. Okay. Now just tell me one more thing. Did you read any, number or letter written on those cups? What is it written?
Yes, there is 1/4 cup, half a cup, 3/4 cup, and one whole cup.
Okay. So that is what is written. And on that measuring tape which you have shown?
Yes. There is centimeters and inches.
Okay, can you show me in your tape which is a centimeter distance?
This is centimeter. And this is inches.
This is inches. Do you have paper in front of you?
Yes, just because if I forget something.
Yeah, that is okay. That is fine. I'm not asking why you have kept a paper. But if you have a paper, can you measure the length of that paper and tell me in centimeters?
Height or width? I mean, length or width?
Whatever. Whichever.
Length is 11.8 inches or 30.5 centimeters. And width is 21 centimeters or 8.3 inches.
Okay, now you have measured 21 centimeter. Is it exact 21 centimeter, or little ahead, or little before it?
21 centimeters, like
exact 21 centimeter, or 21 point something?
It's 21.05 centimeters.
0.5? There is no marking for 0.5, no?
Yeah, but it's in between 21 and 21.1.
Okay. Yeah, but generally we need to do it only where the marking is. Because we don't know exactly, no? But anyway, nice. Okay. Chetali, you can ask.
Yes, ma'am. Well, Abhir, so the next up question for you is, because your entire topic revolved around measurements. right? So do you think of unit when we talk about measurement?
Could you please repeat the question?
Okay, so I just want you to tell me if units are important when you consider measurements.
Yeah, they are pretty important because like if you're measuring something to bake or to cook, you can't have the wrong unit and just measure it in that. So like if they've asked one cup, you can't give one tablespoon.
Okay, cool. Well, the next up question for you is, if at all, see, I'm giving you a comparative study, okay? If at all, I give you 1 kg, now that you have said that, you know, unit is very important. So you have 1 kg of pebbles, stones, and 1 kg of feathers. Which do you think is lighter?
There'll be no difference because 1 kg of pebbles and stones will be quite less, but it'll still be the same weight and also the same with the feathers.
Are we sure? So you basically mean both are same? There is no less, no more?
Yeah, both weights will be the same.
Okay. Well, Aveer, that is pretty much it. Well, I would like to tell you something that I really appreciate the way you had n number of examples right in front of you. And the setup that you had was really nice because you had a variety of examples with you. So I really appreciate that. But also, I would like to suggest that whenever you have such examples, we would give some enough time to them, okay? In the sense, you should be able to do justice with every element that you have, right? But beautifully done, I really appreciate. Thank you.
Very well done, Aveer. Good. We'll let you know the result in a couple of days, okay? See you till then. Bye-bye.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Okay, now it's at 5:45, Anvita Desai, till 6 o'clock, okay?
Okay, yes. Just a minute, huh, Sujata? Let me put the marks, otherwise I will forget.
No, she's not there in waiting room.
Achha, she's not there.
Sorry. Two judges are here. They're going to take your interview. Dr. Patki ma'am from Ruparel College. She is a physics professor. And Ms. Chetali from Sathe College. Okay. So you have to present yourself. Before that, you have to give your introduction. And you have to tell your topic on which you are going to present. Okay. Shall we start? Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. All the best.
Thank you, ma'am. Good evening, judges and teachers. I am Anvita and I will be talking about the topic measurements in daily life. Measurements are divided into different and many sets, from which I am going to talk about mass, volume, and density. Mass. Mass is the amount of matter which makes up a body. Mass of solid and gas is measured in kilograms, grams, and milligrams. Mass of liquid is measured in liters, milliliters, etc. Volume. Volume is the is a measure of space occupied by an object. Volume of solid, liquid, and gas is measured in meter cube or centimeter cube. Density. Density gives us an idea of how closely atoms are packed. Density is measured in kilogram per meter cube or gram per centimeter cube. Density's formula is mass upon volume. By experiment 1, we will see relation between mass and density. Here I have sugar solution, salt solution, and normal water. Here I have potato pieces. Here we can see that potato floats in sugar solution and salt solution, but it sinks in normal water. This is because we have increased mass of water by adding sugar and salt. So we can conclude that salt solution and sugar solution are denser than normal water and potato pieces. We can conclude that if mass increases, density also increases. And if mass decreases, density also decreases. Here I have 1/2 kg puffed rice and 1/2 kg peanuts. Volume of puffed rice is more than volume of peanuts, but density of puffed rice is less than peanuts. We can face the same condition in 100 grams rajgira laddu and 100 grams methi seeds. Here we can conclude that if volume increases, density decreases. And if volume decreases, density increases. We face the same condition in market while buying onions. Wet onions contains moisture, so number of wet onions in 1 kg is less than number of dry onions in 1 kg. My mother buys onions only when dry onions are available. I will give you one more example. When I went sea swimming, I experienced that it is easier to swim in seawater with less efforts than swimming in swimming pool because seawater contains salt and we stay afloat in seawater. And in swimming pool, it is harder to swim. Here we can conclude that seawater is denser than swimming pool. Now, by experiment 2, we will find out that different substances have different densities. Here I have honey, colored water, and oil. Honey is the densest. Colored water is denser than oil, but it is lighter than honey, and oil is the lightest. Here I have a metal nut. Metal nut is denser than all substances, so it goes directly in honey. Here I have a potato. Potato is denser than water, but it is lighter than honey. Here I have a plastic cap. Plastic cap is lighter than water, but it is denser than oil. And here I have thermocol. It is lighter than all substances. We use this principle for food adulteration. For example, Jones of Briggs is mixed in red chili powder. Now in gas, the helium gas, which is used to fill balloons in birthday parties, is lighter than surrounding air, so it rises up. We face the same condition while making dalgona coffee. The mixture of water and coffee is mixed with surrounding air, so its volume increases and density decreases. So it floats on milk. Thank you. I thank Concepts Unlimited for conducting this exam and giving us opportunities.
Animita, don't switch off your video. Yeah.
I'm bad, mister.
Yeah. Okay. Now, Chetali ma'am and Patki ma'am, you can start Vaiva.
Yeah. Shall I ask you, Anvita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yeah. You have done very nice presentation. I liked it so much. You have taken so much pains that you have, showed us almost everything. So there are very little questions now to be asked. Let me ask you one question. Suppose I give you two pieces, okay? Two pieces of something which I don't know. I even don't know they are of same material or different material, okay? My question is, how will you decide that which is more dense and which is less dense, or the density of which piece is more and which piece is less, or is it equal? How will you decide? What yes, experiment ma'am. Will you do?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if one's volume is less, then its density is more than other. And if its volume is more, than its density is less than other. And if they have same volume, then they have same density.
What about mass?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if mass of one substance is more, then its density will be also more than the other. And if its mass is less, then its density will be also less than other.
Means if the pieces are of same size, volume is same,
then
you will use this.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if mass is same, then we will compare its volume.
Correct. And if volume is same, you will compare with mass.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Correct.
Shall I go ahead, ma'am?
Okay, Chetali, you ask. Yeah, you ask the question.
Yes, sure. Well, Anvita, let me tell you that beautiful demonstrations, the various, you know, small collective inputs that you had really had amazing ideology behind it. And it really suggested, you know, so much of clarity with respect to mass, volume, density. So you pretty much covered literally everything about your topic. Well, my questions are going to be two questions for you. Well, when we talk about capacity, okay, when you talk about capacity, can you tell me this terminology is closely related to your mass, volume, or density? What do you think?
It is closely related to volume.
100%.
Yes, ma'am.
Be confident. 100%.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. On that note, let us move to your second question now. Well, there is this another demonstration, because, you know, I am highly inspired by this three cute little setup that you have. So let us imagine one setup now. Okay, we have box A, box B, box C. Okay, now box A, B, and C, they are solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay, now can you tell me what is going to be the difference of densities in A, B, and C? Do you think there can be any difference here?
Yes, ma'am, there will be difference.
Mm-hmm.
Ma'am, the solid will be denser than liquid, and the liquid will be denser than gas.
Okay, cool. Sure, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Well, this is pretty much it from my side, dear. You did absolutely amazing.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Well done. Very good nice. Presentation. Amazing presentation, Anvita. Really. Okay. And we'll let you know your result in a couple of days. And thanks for this such a beautiful things you present in front of us. Okay. Bye bye. See you. Vyomla recharge. Vyom. Now, next student is Vyom.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hello, good evening. Good evening, Vyom. First of all, you have to sit at one place, okay? Means what we are going to present, you have to present it from one place, okay?
Okay, ma'am. Let me keep it.
Be stable, yeah.
Okay, ma'am. So I'm going to give an
overview of the picture. Wait, Vyom. First, I'll introduce our judges. Now, here two judges are there. Dr. Patki, ma'am. From Ruparel College, she is a physics professor, and Chetali Miss from Sathe College. Okay, she is assistant professor at Sathe College. So both of them are going to take your interview. So first of all, you have to give your introduction, your name, and on which topic you are going to present today. So that you have to tell, and then after you have to start your presentation. All the best for your presentation. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can start now.
My name is Vyom Kulkarni from 6th standard. Today I'm going to give an overview of friction, and I'm also going to explain four types of friction. And I'm going to give and show a demo for three of them. So there are four types of friction: static friction, sliding friction, rolling friction, and fluid friction. In fluid friction, it is present in air and water. In water, fluid friction is more than in the air. So I want to show a demo of that fluid friction exists. So if I take this book, I have tied it to a rope at the ceiling. And when I take this over here and leave it, when it comes back, it will have more distance from me from when I had first left it, and it eventually stops. That's because of the friction which is present in the air, which is also called fluid friction. Then I have this bottle. If I slide, now I'm going to show a demo for sliding friction. So if I slide this bottle, it will go ahead, but it will stop after some time due to friction. But if I take the same bottle and roll it, then it will stop. But if after a bit more time, as rolling friction, when while rolling friction has less effect than while sliding. So if I slide this bottle or roll this bottle with the same force and the same bottle, it will roll further than it will slide. And then the last is static friction. In static friction, if you rub a ruler against your hair, and then if you take a paper and then keep the ruler above it, the paper will stick to the ruler. And that's how static friction will be performed. So friction is a force, a contact force. So it will only occur if the object is in contact with the surface on which this force is. So if I keep this bottle in the air, then it will have less effect of friction, but it will be affected by fluid friction. If I keep it on the ground, it will be affected by sliding or rolling friction, but that's only if it is in contact with the ground.
Yes, Vyom, you can go ahead. Is it over?
Yes,
or do you
ma'am.
Want to say something?
No, ma'am. That's all.
Okay. So, can we ask you questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you did very nice presentation. You have showed us very nicely these three examples for
Thank
three
you.
Different frictions. Yeah. Which was the last one? Which was the last one you have just now showed?
It was static friction.
Static friction. Okay, that. Yeah. Okay, that. You said that you can make use of the comb and with the help of a piece of papers.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, you can show that. So when you rub the comb and you held it near those, hold it near, say, those small pieces of paper, that time, when those pieces get attracted to the comb. Have you observed that?
Yes, ma'am. I have.
So, yes, correct. So now tell me, where is the friction here when the pieces of paper get attached to or stick to that comb? Is that because of the friction, or is there any other time where the when the friction is present? When is exactly the friction present in this example?
When you rub the comb against a head, that's where the friction is present.
Okay, correct. Right, you're correct. And other thing, now this book you have placed here in the air by attaching a thread to that, correct? And you showed that book is present. The book, you give it some oscillation, it will oscillate, and afterwards it stops because of the friction, correct?
Yeah.
Now this is a friction between what? The book and
the air,
correct? Now instead of this book, suppose if I use maybe a scale, okay, wooden scale, and I put it like this, say in the same manner, right? And if I observe, if I oscillate it, and if I observe the oscillations, will that same thing happen, that scale will stop oscillating after some time?
Yes, ma'am.
Correct. And if you put that scale, okay, so that whole setup in water, will that same thing will happen?
Yes, but it will happen faster because water has more friction than air.
Correct. Chetali, you can ask.
Sure, ma'am. Well, Vyom, lovely demonstration that you had from your side. It was really nice. Well, on that note, we can move in forward and we can take up one question for you. Do you think friction is an unwanted force, or do you think it is really essential? What do you think? I mean, just your comments on that.
I think it is essential because if we start to travel in a car, we will never be able to stop. And if we don't stop, then we will never reach our destination, and some or the other time we will meet into an accident.
Okay. Very innovative. All right. Well, let us take in, this answer that you have given a little forward. I'll associate another question related on the same lines. Well, we certainly see that, the riding bikes that are there, they have this bigger, huge tires, and it is very, it isn't smooth. Do you think this phenomenon has anything to do remotely with friction?
Yes, ma'am. I think they are so rough that it increases the friction between the ground and the wheels. So it is easier to put a brake.
Okay, cool. Well, this is pretty much it from my side here. You did really well.
Thank you, ma'am.
Excellent presentation, Vyom. Very well done. Amazing setup you have done over there at your end. We'll let you know the result in a couple of days. Okay, thanks for the nice presentation. Yes. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Solid, confident, Akmula.
Zabardast.
तेवढ्यात त्याने काय काय बांधून काय काय तयारी पण केली.
हो, तेच ना.
या सगळ्याचं त्यांच्या वाहिवासाठी जे त्याने प्रिपरेशन केलं असेल, दॅट टू विल हेल्प.
हो सर. हॅलो आद्या, कॅन यू हिअर मी? प्लीज शेअर युअर व्हिडिओ विथ अस. Hello, Adya. Good evening.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Good evening. I said the good evening. It's a clear.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah. Don't switch off your video because you have to share your video with us. Don't put it off. Okay, so today, two judges are here with us. Dr. Mugdha Patki from Ruparel College. She is physics professor and Miss Chetali from Sathe College. She is assistant professor at Sathe College. So both these professors are going to conduct your today's interview. So are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So first of all, you have to give your introduction. Then you have to tell your topic, on which topic you are going to present your today's presentation. That you have to tell. And you have to present in 5 minutes, and then after we'll start your viva. Okay, all the best.
Good evening, teachers. My name is Adya Maurya, sixth grade. I'm going to present some experiments based on friction. Friction is a force that opposes motion. It is a contact force, which means if the two objects are not in contact with each other, they'll not have friction. Friction occurs because of the interlocking of the rough surface.
Slowly. Don't say anything in hurry. Please go little slow. Okay? Be slow.
I think her internet connection is not steady.
Yeah. Adya, can you hear me? Adya? Adya?
Good evening, teachers. My name is Adya Mahare of 6th grade. Today, I'm going to present some experiments based on friction. Friction is a force which opposes motion. Friction is a contact force, which means if the two objects are not in contact with each other, they do not have friction. Friction occurs because of the interlocking of the rough projections between the two surfaces. So, friction opposing motion decreases the efficiency, thus requiring us to do more effort to do the same task. Friction also produces heat. But why does it produce heat? We often rub our hands when we feel cold. While we rub our hands, we produce friction and cause the molecules on our hands to move, vibrate faster and producing more energy, thus more heat. Friction also causes wear and tear. Why does it cause wear and tear? To understand that, we'll be performing simple experiment. We'll be rubbing this eraser across the surface. After rubbing for some time, we'll observe that the eraser is heated a bit as well as it has deformed. It has worn out. Why did it worn out? There's a perpendicular force, that is a force acting at 90 degrees, as well as a proportional force acting. These forces acting at the same time cause the eraser to erode. Now, we often think friction as an annoyance and try to reduce it to its minimal. But in a frictionless world, we won't be able to do our day-to-day activities, such as simple activities of walking, brushing our teeth, and sitting on a chair, occur only because of friction. If no friction, we won't be able to do such simple activities. Sometimes we need to maximize friction. Sometimes we need to minimize it. Let's perform some experiments to understand. To minimize friction, we can smoothen the surfaces. Understand that we'll be moving an object across a smooth surface. Calculate the distance covered and the time taken. Now move the same object across a rough surface. Note down the distance and the time taken. You'll observe that the distance is covered more in the smoother surface and the time is taken less compared to the rougher surfaces. Thus, by smoothing surfaces, we can reduce friction. We can also reduce friction by using lubricants. Lubricants are substances which reduce friction. Some common examples of lubricants are grease and oil, which fill the depressions, making the surface smoother and reducing friction. Lubricants also come in solid form, such as powder. We often put powder on the carom board to reduce friction between the coins and the board. We can also reduce friction by streamlining. To perform that, we perform a simple experiment. We'll be needing two paper planes. Bend a paper plane and then push both the paper planes at the same time. You'll observe that the paper plane, which is streamlined, that is tapering towards the end and compared to the latter, has moved the more distance. Thus, we can state that by streamlining objects, we can reduce friction. We can also reduce friction by using ball bearings. We all know that rolling is much more easier than sliding. So that's why we use ball bearings instead of wheel and axle in most of the machines. Friction can also be maximized. For example, mountaineers need use special shoes called trekking shoes, in which the soles are rough, which provide them extra grip. Thus, we can say that by making the soles rough, by making the surfaces rougher, we can increase friction. We can also increase friction by using dry surfaces. Friction can also be increased by increasing the weight. For example, if you are moving a lighter object across some surface, you'll use less energy. But while moving a heavier object, you use more energy and more friction. Thank you.
Nice. Adya, can I ask you some question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Suppose you are walking on the tar road. Okay. And if you are walking along the seashore, where will be the friction more?
Ma'am, what was the first option?
Tar road. If you are walking on the tar road and you are walking on the sand, that is seashore, along the seashore.
Ma'am, we'll have more friction while we walk on the seashore, because this the sand is coarse and there's more rough projections. But when we walk on a road, the road is cemented and it is smoother. So there'll be more friction while we walk on the sand or seashores.
Okay. So suppose you and your friend, okay, are parallelly walking. On one of you is walking on the road and other one is walking on the seashore, and both the road directions are parallel. Okay, who will need more energy to walk the same amount of distance?
Ma'am, more friction means we'll need more energy. So while walking on the seashore, we'll need to use more energy. But while walking on the cemented road, we'll use less energy.
Okay. And suppose instead of walking, if we consider the example of, water, if you are swimming in the water, then will there be any kind of friction? Or there will be no friction?
Ma'am, friction occurs in solids, liquids, as well as gaseous mediums. While we are swimming, we often put our hands first, and thus we use a streamlined body, and then reducing friction. So, and friction is the most in solid and the least in liquid gases. So, while swimming, there'll be less friction.
You will use? What did you say? I did hear last word. Will you please repeat? I didn't hear you.
We use less energy and there will be less friction.
Okay. I got it. Yeah. Okay. So this less energy means compared to solid, you are saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Or what? Air, you are saying? Okay.
Compared to solid.
Okay.
All right.
Chetali, you can ask.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. Well, Adya, I have two questions for you. Let us start off with the first one. When you talk about industries, okay, let us assume some manufacturing industry wherein we have huge machines, okay? So do you think that such machines are under immense stress, and the efficiency, you know, the product, the efficiency we get of those machines can reduce because of friction?
Yes, ma'am, because friction causes wear and tear, and the efficiency thus reduces. Friction also opposes motion. So we often use lubricants like oil and grease in huge machines to reduce the friction.
Okay, lovely. Well, on that note, let us move to another question. When we see birds, right? Now, their flight is often cherished by all of us. Do you think that they are also facing some huge kind of friction when they're flying?
Ma'am, birds don't face friction because they have a streamlined body, and friction gases is the least. Because of these two factors, they require less energy to fly.
Okay, okay, cool. Well, on that note, Adya, I would like to tell you something, that the content you had throughout for your presentation, the content you prepared was really nice. It was detailed, it was nice. One small piece of advice would be that if at all you can just slow your pace a little, trust me, it is going to be wonders for you. Okay, so next time, what you'll do is, because your content is amazing, your voice, your pitch, everything is amazing. Okay, just one factor, and that is the pace. All right, so we'll go a little slow. Pakka.
Okay, ma'am.
All right, amazing. On that note, you did a great job. Thank you, dear.
Well done, Adya. Good, good presentation. And we'll let you know the result in a couple of days. Thanks a lot.
Bye. Thank you. Bye, ma'am.
Bye, dear.
Bye.
Bye. एकदम जोरात गाडी होती
ऍक्च्युअली
याचा अर्थ तिला खूप माहित होत तिला खूप सांगायचं होतं म्हणून तिला असं वाटलं असणार त्या वेळेत पुरत की नाही धडधड धडधड सगळं सांगून टाकलं
ऍक्च्युअली तिने 15 मिनिटांचं प्रेझेंटेशन केलं आणि 5 मिनिट्स बिफोर आम्हाला आता फोन केला आणि विचारलं की मला किती मिनिटं मिळणार आहे सो आम्ही म्हंटल 5 मिनिटं मी खूप प्रेझेंट करायचंय म्हणून मी म्हणलं स्लो जा
म्हणून तिचं असं झालं म्हणून तिला ते सगळं अगदी सांगून टाकायचं होतं तिच्याकडे खूप डेटा होता पण कसं सांगू संपवू कसं असं झालं असणार तिला
ओके आय सजेस्ट वन थिंग सुजाता टीचर इफ शी हॅज प्रिपेअर्ड सो वेल अ कंटेंट ऑफ 15 मिनिट्स तिला ते करू दे प्रेझेंट घरी व्हिडिओ घेऊ देत आपण तिचा व्हिडिओ आपल्या वेबसाईटवर अपलोड करूया नंतर तिला बोलू देत 15 मिनिटं जे काय तिचा कंटेंट आहे तो तिच्या शांत चित्ताने जसं चेताली मिसने तिला सांगितलं So you to after today's presentation, you just suggest her to do that 15 minutes presentation okay. and make a recording of that and send it to us.
Okay.
Or otherwise we can have a Zoom meeting with her. She can present in front of us that time.
And we will record.
But तिला बरं वाटेल की तिने content तयार केलेला काहीतरी उपयोगी पडला.
Okay, so next one is Surbhi Agrawal. She will join maybe in 5 minutes. What happened, Jayashree?
Stop. Even when we do not apply the brakes or we stop pedaling, or for that matter, a ball rolling across the playground stops rolling after some time. Or this little piece of wooden block, when I push it across the surface, it stops after covering some distance. Have you ever wondered why? There must be something acting upon the moving bicycle or the rolling ball or this piece of wooden block which made it stop. And that something is friction, which is my today's topic, and more particularly, it is V and frictional force. The flow of my presentation is to take you through one, to explain what is friction, two, real life examples around us. And through these, I will explain one, advantages and disadvantages of friction, and two, how can we modify friction to our advantage? So first, let us understand what is friction. Friction is actually a force. We know that a force is the interaction of a push or a pull due to an object. Now, frictional force is a force which acts in the direction opposite to the direction of the motion. So, when two bodies come in contact with each other, they slide or they move over each other. Now, example. When I push this wooden block on the surface, it stops after covering some distance, which means that there is frictional force present between the surface of the book and the lower surface of the block. So, when I push the block moved forward, so the frictional force acted in the opposite direction. Now, frictional force has mainly two reasons. One, smoothness of the surface. No matter how smooth the surface may look, it will always have minute irregularities present when looked through a microscopic lens, like these. So, when two surfaces come in contact with each other, these irregularities interlock with each other, which results in friction. So, when surfaces are smooth, there will be less interlocking, so there will be less friction. And when surfaces are rough, there will be more interlocking, so there will be more friction. Now, the second factor, frictional force increases with the increase in the hardness of the substance. Now, let me take you through some real-life examples which I'm sure you all must have encountered. First, we should always be careful while walking on a wet floor or on a wet road during monsoons. Or we should not drive a vehicle with worn-out tires. Why? It is because water on the floor reduces the friction and makes the surface smooth and slippery. Hence, we tend to lose our grip and fall. Now, the second example. I play badminton. So I have this racket on, I have this grip on my racket handle. Why? It is because the grip tends to absorb the sweat, and so it increases the friction between my hand and the grip. Some other examples of friction at work are, I can write with a pencil or a pen on paper and with a chalk on a board. I can even hold objects. Then I can light a matchstick, and even I can rub my palms to increase the heat in winter. Now, in all these examples, friction works to our benefit. On the other hand, there are examples where friction is undesirable. So, what do? Well, we try and reduce it. Like, while playing carom, I sprinkle 5 powder on the carom board so that to make the surface smooth. The slide on the playgrounds are often polished so that the children can slide down easily. My father oils the hinges of the doors when they creak and even applies grease to my cycle wheels. And there are wheels fitted to this suitcase. Why? It is because the wheels reduce the resistance to the motion and helps me pull the suitcase easily. And there are even ball bearings which are used to reduce the friction like these. Now we learn from nature too. Birds and fishes glide effortlessly in the air and water. Why? Because nature has given them streamlined bodies to reduce the friction. This has inspired humans to make models like aeroplanes, sports cars, ships, and many other vehicles. Now, friction brings along disadvantages too, like machines become less efficient when heat is generated between their moving parts, and increase of wear and tear in surfaces of soles of my shoes and even tires of vehicles. Now I know whom to blame when I need a new pair of shoes often. So, in conclusion, it is necessary, friction is necessary in our daily lives, but it is avoidable at many times, but working for us in our daily activities. Thank you.
Very nice. Surbhi, can we start asking you questions?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Surbhi, my question is, suppose if I have a ball which weighs 100 grams, and I have another block which also weighs 100 grams. And if I'm going to move them or slide them on a plane surface, where will be the friction more and where will be the friction less? In which case friction is more and which case friction is less?
The friction will be more in the block case and the friction will be less in the ball case.
Do you know the reason?
Yes, ma'am, because since the ball, the surface is round and it is very smooth, hence the interlocking will be less, so the friction will be less versus in the block. The surface will be rough, so the friction will be more because there will be more interlocking.
Okay. Suppose if I want to reduce the friction of block, okay, is there a way to do that?
Yes.
Ball, as you said, because yes. Go ahead.
Because I can oil it or either I can grease it.
With that, it will have lesser friction.
Yes, ma'am.
And does this friction depends upon mass of that object, or
yes,
it depends upon surface of the object.
Friction depends upon the surface of the object, the nature of the surface.
And if when that block or ball is placed on the on some surface, what is the direction of the friction?
The friction will act in the opposite direction, ma'am.
Chetali, you can ask.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Well, Surbhi, let me tell you something, that your entire flow of presentation that you had planned was really amazing because it had a story in itself. You know, you did proper justice with the entire story that you wanted to narrate, and let me tell you, it reached us very clearly. Well, on that note, let us have two questions for you, all right? So, the first question is, I'll give you some examples only because, you know, I'm very impressed with the way you have presented. So even I would like to give you some examples, you know. So if at all we, you know, want to open a jar, all right, most of the time it happens that, you know, you want to open something, but then it is very tight. What your mom suggests is take that napkin, all right, and then try to open it up. So what cloth material would you prefer? Will you go for, you know, cotton napkin, or rather you'll go for silk material? What do you choose?
I would go for the cloth napkin.
Mm-hmm.
Since the surface will be rough, the grip on the cloth napkin on the jar and on the jar handle, I can be able to grip it firmly. So I'll be able to open it nicely.
Okay, cool. All right. On that note, let us go to another example for you. This time, let us take your stationery box. All right. So when you open a stationery box, obviously the very immediate thing that you'll probably see is a pen, right? So let us take two comparative study here. We have this single pen. I hope you're able to see it. Right? Yes. Okay. So this is one pen, and another one, just imagine, I don't have it right now here. That pen, imagine that it has one rubber placed here. We know, right? We have some pens which have rubber here, right? Which amongst these two pens you feel that it will be easy for you to write?
It will be the pen with the rubber grip, because since rubber, the surface of the rubber is rough, so the friction between my fingertip and the rubber will be more, so I'll be able to hold the pen firmly and write nicely.
Okay, well, this is pretty much it from my side here. Thank you so much.
Very good, Surbhi. Very nice presentation. Very good. Whatever you have done, the backside, it's really excellent. Nicely presented this topic, that is VN, frictional force. Okay, the result will let you know in a couple of days. And thanks for such a nice and amazing presentation. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
I will fill up that sheet what you have sent, Sujata, and I will email it to you.
Okay, ma'am. No worry. Okay.
There is no need to discuss. Now we need to discuss and write or something like that.
No, not required.
Nahi.
You can fill the sheets and just email me. Uh-huh. So accordingly, we'll put up in our system and we'll do that.
Okay.
We'll send you the certification or invitation also. Thank you. Yes, ma'am. Sorry.
Yes. Yeah, madam.
Same thing. I was about to say same thing. 26 January, we'll meet again. By then, and thank you so much. It was really good experience for us also, and I hope you must have also enjoyed
for it. Us it was very innovative experience. Chote chote mulanchi bolna and tensi solid idea mast
एकदम जेन्युइन असतात त्यांना तर भीती वाटत
आणि
थोडं तुम्ही शिकवता कॉलेजच्या मुलांना
त्यांचे क्वेश्चन्स पण खूप असे इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन असतात त्यांचे आणि विचारायला अजिबात घाबरत नाही. काही असू दे, छोट्यातला छोटा पण आमच्याशी डिस्कस करतात डिस्कशन सेशन्स मध्ये. खूप छान आहे ती मुलं.
आणि आई वडिलांनी सांगून पटत नाही ते आई वडिलांनी किती पण समजून सांगितलं तरी शेवटी तर आम्ही सांगितलं आमच्यापर्यंतच येतं ते नेहमीच मुलांचं तसंच असतं. it was a real pleasure to meet both of you. Chetali ya nimittane tuji olakh zali. Mukda madam amchakade amcha madatila nehmi astat. She is available just at one phone call, and now you will also be, I think.
So. Definitely, ma'am. I mean, it will be my pleasure, just in case, you know, I get this opportunity again, because trust me, it was so enlightening to hear, you know, such small students, but then the way they present, I mean, I'm really enlightened. It's so inspiring. Seriously. Mm-hmm. It was really nice. Really, really nice. Yeah. Thank you so much.
आणि सगळ्यांनी एकदम छान तयारी केली होती सगळी.
हो. मला पण अनएक्सपेक्टेड होतं आणि आम्ही काही सांगितलं नाही. म्हणजे त्यांचे काय काय बोल येत होते की आम्ही काय बोलू, आम्ही हे करू का. आम्ही म्हटलं आम्ही काहीच सांगणार नाही. आम्ही फक्त गाईडलाईन दिल्या की एवढं प्रेझेंट करायचं आहे आणि काहीही करा, फक्त पीपीटी करायचं नाही, कुठलंही रिटर्न
करायचं, मॉडेल मेकिंग नाही सांगितलं,
मॉडेल मेकिंग नाही, पीपीटी नाही, घरातल्या वस्तू वापरून करायचं. सो यू डिसाइड व्हॉट एव्हर. बरं झालं ते, कारण मग नाहीतर रिस्ट्रिक्ट होत. सो दे फ्री टू डू व्हॉट
वॉन्टेड टू. आणि मग नंतर ते विचार त्याच डायरेक्शननी जातात. आता कसं काहीही करा म्हटल्यावरती विचार पण सगळ्या बाजूचे असतात, त्यामुळे आता विषय सेम होता पण कोणाचं सारखं नव्हतं. प्रत्येक जण आपल्या आपल्या डोक्यानी केलं.
इट वॉज नाईस. सो गुड. एनिवे
थँक्यू मॅम.
चलो बाय बाय.
ओके bye
bye Chetani. Bye, bye ma'am.
See you all.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye ma'am.
Bye bye.
Bye Chetani.
आपण इथूनच बोलू म्हणून
आज तरी मी इतक्या वेळा जागा बदलली.
उद्याची मीटिंग आत्ता घ्यायची का? उद्याची मीटिंग आत्ताच घेऊया का?
नको नको, उद्याच घेऊया मीटिंग. बरेच मुद्दे आहेत उद्या आपल्याला बोलायला.
नाही मी असंच बोलली
कारण आपल्याला ह्या सगळ्या फायनल पण ठरवायचे 26 जानेवारीचं, आणि इतर गोष्टी पण जरा उद्या फायनलाइज करायच्या.